Ladies and gentlemen, the presentation that follows is a selection of the developments that have taken place lately in BETA CAE Systems product line. I will start with an outline of the presentation. Our suite consists of four main flagship products: the well-known ANSA Pre and MetaPost processor, the constantly expanding SPDRM, standing for Simulation, Process, Data and Resources Management, and the new member of the family, our brand new solver Epilysis. Let's see where and how our products stand in the CAE analysis workflow. Approaching the CAE analysis from the process perspective, we will begin with the porting of data from the PDM systems into the preprocessor. Then we will discuss about the meshing solutions of the ANSA preprocessor and continue with introduction to our brand new solver Epilysis. Next, we will jump to the model building phase with the setup of the simulation model featuring disciplines, tools, processes, results post-processing included. From the data perspective, the number and the diversity of data render the use of some data management system more than essential. We'll spend some time on that too. So let's start with the first step of the typical CAE process, the porting of data from a PDM system to ANSA preprocessor. The PDM to CAE process brings two main challenges. First is the accessibility. The PDM to CAE process is demanding and cumbersome exactly because it lies on the boundary between design and analysis. Therefore, it requires that either a single person has knowledge of tools of both domains or that people from both domains cooperate closely with each other. Both these prerequisites make the process hardly accessible by a large group of analysts and require the constant involvement of process gurus. Second is the addition of value to the generated CAE model. In order to further reduce the CAE turnaround time, it is necessary to extract numerous CAD metadata to be used during FE model preparation in order to enable the automation of several tasks and to ensure the reuse of data whenever possible. We offer a comprehensive solution package for bridging PDM with CAE directly integrated in ANSA. It consists of two main ingredients. First, an interface to the PDM systems, and second, an integrated data management system which serves as a backbone library of parts. Regarding the actual interface to the PDM systems, ANSA offers out-of-the-box hard-coded support of the product structure formats exported from all major PDM systems. PLM-XML format exported from Teamcenter, VSMOCKUP and SMORACT, ISOSTEP developed by ProStep, FATXML, StepXML, and VPN from Innovia. Additionally, ANSA offers a scripting interface for reading any other product structure format. Since a product structure file can either describe a single variant or a multivariant model, ANSA supports both definitions, 100% and 150% models, single body in wide, 100%, or long version, short version, sunroof, etc., 150%. After the reading of the files, their contents are displayed in the product tree editor, which is the main workspace for the processing of the model before its actual import into the preprocessor. This process is further enhanced with the usage of ANSA DM. The differentiation of the CAE tree of the PDM tree, the handling of carryover parts and multi-position parts, the management of model variants, and the maintenance of design metadata in the CAE model. The results of the aforedescribed process are illustrated on screen, where we can see the result CAE model in ANSA preprocessor. All involved parts are either translated or retrieved from DM. All the involved parts are merged in the current ANSA DB. All the model variants are referenced in the PDM product tree and included in the merged model, 150% model. The complete product tree is imported in the Parts Manager. Metadata are imported in Parts Manager as user attributes. And last but not least, all the newly translated parts are automatically stored in ANSA DM. ANSA preprocessor is already well known as the most competent mesh model generator, combining process efficiency, robustness and automation with high quality results and a significantly reduced meshing time regardless of user's experience. Let's see what we are up to lately in order to ensure this top position. ANSA version 16 comes with brand new approach and solutions we offer watertight model handling, such as the one illustrated on screen, exterior acoustics applied on engine block, body paint, bone in white, and CFD applications. Furthermore, since version 16, we have the introduction of directional fuse of parts, i.e. the watertight model creation from unconnected panels, such as the one illustrated on screen, which versus the, let's say, typical wrap approach, offers excellent feature capturing, excellent mesh quality, and all this through a significantly robust process. Moreover, a new tool regarding welded structure assembly has also been introduced lately. Initially, there is a model of solid description parts where each one is separately closed, so the model is not one volume as a whole. This tool performs fully automatic connection of skin parts by extending, intersecting, and deleting the unnecessary elements. The automatic simplification of flanges is also included in this process. Although ANSA already has a prominent position in the field of automation and repeatability of its meshing and not only operations, we keep establishing and complementing new techniques and processes. Towards this direction, in cases where similar groups are detected in the model, a new copy mesh algorithm can create identical mesh among them, thus significantly decrease the overall modeling time and efficiently eliminate the human error factor. The time has come to introduce our brand new solver Epilysis, designed to solve large-scale models with advanced in and out of core capabilities. Epilysis can be considered as a general-purpose finite element analysis software with high accuracy and performance computing capabilities, integrating many solutions in one solver such as structural, linear and nonlinear analysis, dynamics and substructuring. On top of that, Epilysis is exclusive for its top quality and robustness, offering high accuracy and performance with a quick learning approach for inexperienced user and, above all, being affordable for even small and medium-sized enterprises. The setup of the simulation model in our software reflects a deep understanding of the demands of simulation and its role in enterprise. Towards this direction, we have introduced the model browser in ANSA version 16, which offers a direct reference to all entities that belong to a part or group. In other words, it offers the direct reference to parts, connections, variants, subsystems, and part associations as well. Its contents can be considered as a mini database browser, a property list, material list, and connections list, with full customization capabilities of its layout as well. Furthermore, the connection templates approach enables the control of connections and representation settings in groups. Through the connection template manager, an interface that is very much like the batch mesh manager, a collection of connections is loaded to an assembly scenario and then groups of rules per connection type categorize the connections in groups. So each group is associated with a connection template. Applying the scenario assigns the specified template to the connections of each group and consequently the proper FE representation settings. All this information is stored within the connection template, which can be reapplied for future use without the need to reload the respective data. Moreover, when ANSA is assisted by a library of model data, it can also offer alternative reduced representations for parts and subassemblies. The concept of must-trim items is introduced in ANSA in order to address the problem of the proper representation of components by mass elements while targeting on the correct mass distribution of the product. So, must-trimming procedure can be further enhanced to offer easier substitution of parts by masses that are spread over nearby parts. Among other things, this tool offers automatic detection of the nearby parts where the masses will be spread, as well as adjustment of the portion of the trim area that should be mapped on the structure. Moreover, manual adjustments of the trim area and the results are recorded by the tool so that the mass trim item can be erased or even transferred to another model and still be able to be reapplied, respecting all manual adjustments, and all this with a full control over the result. Nowadays, the CAD and CAE models are becoming increasingly complex, while more changes and updates necessarily take place before the final model is ready for release. The need for fast and accurate comparison and matching of different versions of a model or even of different models is more than essential and renders the use of high efficient pre-processing software more than demanding. Towards this direction, as a general overview with Compare tool, it is possible to efficiently compare the geometrical differences of two models, no matter if they are mesh geometries, FE models, or solid descriptions. To easily create a new model by combining characteristics of two existing models. To effortlessly update an existing model when updates of several parts become available. To successfully create a comparison report with the identified references in PPTX, PDF, and TOREX LSX format, as well as a common 150% model for the control of several model variants for a single ANSA database. Furthermore, version 16 introduces new model comparison technology. Through the new multi-model technology, multiple models or variants of one model can be loaded and displayed all together concurrently or in parallel in multiple windows and tiled horizontally or vertically, cascaded, viewed docked, or in full screen mode. This multi-model technology prevents the case of conflicting KID's PIDs during the loading process via performed renumbering, thus ensuring a radical cut down on errors in the final results. However, the main advantage of this new technology is that the user can proceed with direct comparison of the loaded models or variants, such as the distance between two different loaded variants as displayed in the illustrated cases, instead of performing the classic merging process with all the drawbacks that follow. Closing these sections, with ABAC assembly and PAMGRAS module in META, the model can be successfully and efficiently organized in substructures and includes accordingly, facilitating the user even more during the model build-up phase. So let's move on with some per-discipline analysis, starting with the NVH analysis. Along with all the integrated shell and volume meshing algorithms, ANSA provides meshing solutions focused on acoustic simulations, such as the exterior wrap for acoustics, as well as the new hexadominant generator for cavity, leading to a drastic reduction of the created elements. However, one of the biggest challenges in full vehicle simulation is dealing with modeling complexity. NVH-CAE analysis can be very demanding in terms of time and CPU performance, especially for iterations with full vehicle models. This situation renders the development of NVH model reduction techniques more than mandatory. We approach this model reduction and build-up concept in the NVH field through the super elements, which is a form of substructuring, via the NVH console, whose aim is to create reduced representation of components in a streamlined and automated manner. The whole concept is based on a two-step superelement creation. First reduction phase, second assembly run by aid of NVH console and Nastran. At the end of the process, we have a display model, either of shells or plotels or both, for assessing the eigenmode results in META. Last but not least, Nastran solution 111 can be launched directly within NVH console in order to analyze the whole assembly. Complementary to that, A broad range of features and calculation options makes our software package an efficient environment for handling all NVH pre- and post-processing requirements. A sensitivity analysis can be conducted in META in order to investigate which of the bushing settings of a connector is at most sensitive by calculating the partial derivatives of the stiffness, structural, and viscous damping. Frequency and change in structural and acoustic responses can be calculated swiftly and easily inside META, either as curves in the 2D plot or as field data for contour display. So META Model Response Tool calculates frequency response functions, FRFs, and transient responses from the model results. Pressure responses of coupled fluid structure problems can also be calculated. Transfer path analysis shows the contribution of the connecting forces and the related transfer functions from the driving degree of freedom to the response degree of freedom for each partial pressure result. Contour display for 3D post-processing, as well as magnitude phase, real imaginary, polar 3D plots, and contribution color maps are used to support a broad range of model response results, including bundle participation factors, normalized group participation factors, model participation factors, and acoustic results, for example, from exterior analysis. We proceed with the calculation of the contributions for structural model participations so as to identify the structural modes that contribute most to the total noise. We also display this as a polar plot for the frequency where the peak was observed. So the analyst can automatically recognize which mode has the highest contribution to the total noise and to which component this mode belongs to, as well as the time needed for that calculation. Squeak and Rattle Toolbar evaluates the relative displacement between two parts using the E-line method. From pre to post, it creates E-lines in ANSA, connection lines arbitrary, CBUS arbitrary, and evaluates the results in META producing scalar and vector results. Last but not least, since version 15, we have the introduction of Nastran poroelastic materials. These Nastran entities simulate poroelastic materials and their glue, for example, the carpet bonded on the floor permanently. BETA Suite offers a broad range of automated tools and functionalities for the definition of the modeling steps of durability analysis, while efficiently supporting popular codes such as Nastran, Abacus, and ANSYS. Towards this direction, the Contacts Assistant guides the definition of contact interfaces of areas of interest, offering a preview, plane interaction, massive modification capabilities, and many more. While all required steps of pretension definition are integrated in the single stepwise tool, the Pretension Assistant, where the vector and section are prescribed with minimum user interaction. Moreover, durability analysis models typically consist of an assembly body in white and the subsystem under loading. Quite often, though, in order to reduce solution time, a problem is studied on a smaller scale. To address this, ANSA offers the model cut functionality, and as a special case of model cut, ANSA can generate models for Abacus substructure analysis. This tool allows the manipulation of the generated data, the reusability of the generated substructures, and the easy creation of load case variations. Not to be missed, the considerable development process that has taken place during all these years in the ANSYS deck, and as a representative example, we have the ANSYS multi-step analysis, through which the user can perform multiple analyses or multiple types of analysis at the same time as illustrated on screen. More tools and solutions for durability analysis, such as the strain gauges tool. In order to validate mesh models with actual structure, we have developed this tool, whose main and basic idea is the correlation of FE versus actual structure, in other words, the correspondence between FE models and measurements. In the beginning, we have a dynamic static load case, and the user had to perform linear combination in order to see how strain varies over time. In this way, the user could make out how good the simplification is by using FE. Keep in mind that the finer the mesh at the specific area of interest, the easier the identification of the point of measurement, which in complicated models like the one illustrated on screen is a really tedious and cumbersome task. So, in brand new version 16, all the aforementioned steps have been combined into one. After the input of FE model, the user applies the new strain gauges tool and automatically gets the measurement results. Moreover, a new toolbar is introduced that helps in post-processing of critical areas or inner areas of complex structures. The toolbar guides the user to easily set fringe colors to specific groups while automatically setting transparency to the rest of the model. Creation and handling of annotation in critical areas and more is also guided through the toolbar, providing an easier and faster post-processing. Stress linearization can now be easily performed in META via the definition of parametric point paths. After a path or many is created, the user needs to reload the necessary results for the specific paths and the calculations are applied. Then curves of the membrane, bending, etc. results or a full report in the spreadsheet editor can be created directly. Closing this section with solutions for fatigue analysis, full support of NASA embedded fatigue keywords is a reality. Using this bulk data, the user can directly define in ANSA the cyclic material properties, cyclic loading definitions, and various other parameters. Using these bulk data entries, the user can perform many fatigue analyses in order to predict life, damage, factor of safety, etc. Despite the continuously increasingly demanding requirements in the crash and safety field, BETA has responded quickly and successfully to all upcoming challenges by integrating solutions both in ANSA pre and META post-processor. Starting with the pedestrian safety field, all pedestrian safety protocols are now supported and can be easily embedded in the CA workflow. With a highlight of the Euro NCAP version 8.1, the latest pedestrian testing protocol, apart from the already existing ones. Moreover, crash safety analysis can be realized completely inside META through a great variety of tools for the standardization of crash analysis procedures. Such a tool is the pedestrian toolbar with which a pedestrian safety analysis can be performed according to the latest regulations, which generates automatically an HTML PPTX report containing GIF animations, plots, etc. Head form, leg form, and upper leg analysis can be also performed. And Euro NCAP score calculation is also included in this toolbar. In the same manner, in the occupant safety field, all occupant safety protocols are supported and easily embedded in the CEA workflow. Getting deeper into occupant safety field, considering the seat as the basis of the site impact simulation test, the first task that an engineer faces is the positioning of the seat according to all regulations. ANSA has implemented a special tool that moves the seat kinematic mechanism according to each step of all site impact regulations and, in the end, produces and saves the final position that the seat must have. The result of running the seat positioning tool of ANSA is a list of saved positions that correspond to the final position of its regulation and some user-defined ones from sensitivity analysis. This means that from the design position of the seat, one can move at any time to the desired position. These saved positions are being kept during the process setup with the use of ANSA comments. Moreover, an LSDyna file with ANSA comments will be saved containing all those saved positions for the massive load case production at a later step. After the positioning and handling of the dummy, I, after applying all the needed movements to the damaged limbs, the next step is to save this position as the final position for each seat position, either according to a regulation or a user-defined one. As a result, there will be a list of dummy saved positions. These positions will be saved in an LS-DYNA file with ANSA comments that will be used in the final step of the process for the massive load case creation. In MetaPost Processor, a new tool, the Occupant Injury Criteria tool, automates the extraction of occupant injury results. Simulation and test results can be processed either simultaneously or separately. LS-DYNA, PAMCARS and RADIUS results are supported, as well as results from many different variants of the model can be read and processed simultaneously. For each selecting variant, results for up to 4 different dummies can be created. These results are overlaid. Last but not least, results of different model variants are created in the same plots if they result for the same dummy. More tools of MetaPost Processor in the crash analysis field: the Meta Correlation Toolbar, which is the core perspective for crash and not only results correlation based on the weighting factor. The Diff Crash Toolbar, in order to analyze scatter of crash simulation results within Meta. And last but not least, video tracking new features for 2D grid definition, coordinate system definition, manual tracking step by step, as well as prediction when losing track. All CFD needs are covered in a single environment through BETA software, offering high efficiency solutions for CFD applications in various sectors, as well as capabilities to easily handle and explore extremely large and complex models. So let's see what we are up to lately. First of all, we have the boundaries interface and detection and handling tool introduced with version 16. It checks the accuracy and validity of the CFD model in terms of the boundaries and interface's accuracy and validity. After checking the boundary condition type, unconnected regions, or if a property needs to be split, as a next step, it proceeds with suggested solutions to overcome the detected problems, even with the creation of conformal and non-conformal interfaces. CFD results can be successfully mapped from Meta to ANSA. Since version 15, it is possible to create surfaces from geometry files such as STL, VRML, and Nastran. Surface integrals can be also calculated on surfaces and ties of surfaces. Path lines and particle tracks can be created using the streamlines tool, with the addition of streak lines, which is a new type of flow path, a new feature for Meta, and can be calculated for both mass and massless particles, streak lines and particle streaks accordingly. Particle tracks can be calculated by Meta based on gravitational and drag forces, with the additional feature of particle tracking rebound. A new feature for CFD and not only application, the flying camera GUI is also introduced with ANSA version 16. And not to be missed, significant developments such as the full support of tau input-output files in ANSA, as well as the PowerFlow native results in Meta. TechFlow files are supported and have been further enhanced with particle supports, ASCII binary files, as well as OpenFOAM FEMZIP files are supported and have been further optimized with multi-threaded input-output. New tools for the modeling, simulation, and analysis of the behavior of products made of fiber, reinforced, laminate composites comes with brand new version 16. Using the laminates tool, developed and integrated within ANSA preprocessor, the analyst can master the laminates model to be submitted to the solver. Through the new integrated ramming algorithms, woven layer pairs can be merged and handled as a single layer. This integrated ramming algorithm is based on rosettes with start and stack directions. Furthermore, it can calculate fiber orientation and preview shearing, as well as calculate and preview thickening of woven fabrics. Moreover, full support of solid laminate composites is now a reality for Nastran, Abacus and Tanzis with their respective properties. Shell elements with composite or laminate properties can be converted to solid laminates. They can be manipulated under laminate tool with the same manner as the shells. The conversion can be done both for single solid element and for per-ply solid elements. And at any time, the stacking can be converted from single to per-ply and vice versa. The solver results from the analysis of products made of composite materials can be processed by MetaPost processor for evaluation, report generation, and decision-making towards the design improvement. In order to accommodate the requirements of the analysis of these results, Meta offers the Composite Post Toolbar, a set of integrated specialized functionalities collected into a single user interface. So with MetaPost Composite Post Toolbar, it is possible to process various failure criteria, identify the layer with the max failure, as well as the critical direction. It is also possible to isolate failed elements, plot results through thickness, and re-evaluate the failure criteria by modifying the material limits. During product manufacturing process, an overview of the design prototype's motion behavior is really essential for engineer in order to understand and perceive how moving bodies interact with each other. For this reason, we have introduced the kinetics module in ANSA, which can be considered as an integrated multi-body dynamic software incorporating an in-house solver. Among other features, it studies the kinematic dynamic behavior of mechanical systems that undergo large displacements. Furthermore, it manipulates simple or complex mechanisms efficiently according to their kinematics. And speaking of large displacements, kinetics can be used as well in sequential couple simulations that involve motion. In cases like a typical sliding door slam test, the displacements of the bodies are too large, and therefore the solution using an FE solver requires high computation times and high solver resources. Another interesting feature illustrated on the specific video is the animated camera. It lets the user play and view animations from a shifting observation viewpoint that changes while the animation progresses. Not to be missed that both these two videos displayed have been created through data exchange with Blender, a rendering software, through Python scripting. Furthermore, using kinetics and the configurator functionality, users can build their own user-defined configurations that each of them will represent a mechanism of a model. Then they are able to run position-based simulation on them in several ways. For example, in a crash and safety analysis, each saved position of the dummy seat mechanisms can be a different load case to be solved. Another co-simulation process can be considered the advanced tire modeling using kinetics using the F-tire formulation. Moreover, version 16 comes with a new feature in its module, so now we have the full support of contact modeling, non-smooth contacts introduced since version 14 and smooth contacts introduced in version 16. Moreover, full support of parametric simulations is now a reality in version 16. User can now build parameterized multi-modi models and run parametric simulations, such as a design study as well as a design of experiments. Version 16 comes with new solutions in the stamping area. So, towards this direction, we have in the MetaPost processor the Dyn adaptive and remesh support with tracking of mesh differences as displayed on screen and other features such as identification of planes and ISO functions, annotations, log manager, trajectories, parametric points, and many more. Apart from the combination with all popular optimization codes, BETA Suite offers a vast variety of tools for optimization applications. Let's see what we are up lately. We have the automatic 2D or 3D ribs creation based on plane definition through a single stepwise tool. This can be achieved with interactive modification. Automatic intersection and pasting the attached structure takes place so that individual volumes will be created for later solid meshing. The user can also proceed with specific feature handling and creation, such as the fillet creation as illustrated on screen. In the MetaPost area, with the topometry optimization toolbar, it is possible to post-process results from topometry optimization, calculate the relative thickness and output results to ANSA. At this point, we should just take a short break from the presentation flow and emphasize the fact that apart from the tools and major features that we constantly expand and develop in ANSA and MetaSuite, we always keep an eye on the single user's performance and productivity. Towards this direction, we keep providing the user from version to version with enhanced model handling techniques, leading to improved process automation through standardization, reusability, and repeatability of tasks. All this has a result, a significant memory reduction and an accelerated user performance, resulting in a reinforced overall process consistency and a significant boost in productivity. Let's see some examples towards this direction. In ANSA preprocessor, for example, we have the new option to provide full compatibility between major versions as well as advanced model handling techniques. In MetaPost processor, we have now reduced size of MetaDB as well as a new read GUI through which the user can read multiple results at once, as well as the option to save U3D and U3D PDF files, which can directly open from Acrobat Reader. In this file, the user can pan the model and also simulate it. As mentioned in the beginning, data management is unquestionably one of the most critical factors that contribute to the efficiency and productivity of CAE teams. We offer scalable solutions that can manage data either with a file-based approach through ANSA or with a database through the SPDRM server or any third-party SDM system. Meta now has also data management capabilities, equipping the CAE analyst with a complete solution covering all data management needs, from parts and subsystems to simulation runs and results. Additionally, today we introduce a new program, the SDM Console, an innovative simulation data management platform for the interactive browsing, visualization and handling of all data related to CAE analysis. Finally, the ASAM ODS Open Data Services is a standard that specifies a common data structure and interfaces to store and retrieve data in ODS servers. BETA CAE Systems developed an ASAM ODS browser specifically designed to ensure flexibility, performance and ease of use in navigating and querying ASAM ODS data sources. So let's have a quick overview of each one of these solutions. As mentioned in the beginning, ANSA alone offers data management capabilities in the area of CAE preprocessing. ANSA can create and maintain a data repository in a directory in the file system without the need for a database. In the same manner, Meta has direct access to this data repository and update it with simulation runs, reports, etc. accordingly. This solution is suitable for small and medium-sized teams. So, when we're talking about data management in pre- and post-processing, we are talking about a common interface accessible from ANSA, Meta and SDM console that is not only a viewer but also a session executor. However, SPDRM offers data management in a broader spectrum, covering the needs of the complete CAE process. Our solutions come with a default data model that consists of the basic CAE data items: parts, components, simulation models and runs. This data model can be fully customized according to the customer's needs in order to support custom metadata, either to hold information coming from the PDM systems or CAE specific information. The view of the data is also customizable so that it better adapts to each customer's requirements. So in the specific example, we have the components preview and its contents view, the full hierarchy, and the history view with the status of the runs accordingly. While in this case, we have the simulation model with its load case, run, and results, and we can have the contents view of the simulation models, the history view accordingly, plus the pedigree view, through which the user can go one step further, or preferably, let's say, one level deeper, and compare the status of the runs and what has gone wrong in each one. Furthermore, today we introduce a new program, the SDM console, that offers a direct interface to the data management system and an enhanced GUI for data browsing and for the creation and editing of the CA structure. Through the SDM console GUI, several processes can be initiated with the aid of Python scriptings. Last but not least, the ASAM ODS Open Data Services is a standard that specifies a common data structure and interfaces to store and retrieve data in ODS servers. So BETA CAE Systems had developed an ANSAM ODS browser embedded in META, the post-processor of BETA CAE Systems, and included in the standard package at no extra cost. META ASAM ODS browser provides a simple and intuitive user interface for browsing data stored in compliance with the ASAM ODS standard. By simply connecting to an ASAM ODS database, META can display and then plot the data. Closing with the process automation, we all fully recognize its necessity as the leading force to a drastic reduction of the CA turnaround time, offering process standardization, reusability, and repeatability. So far, this is achieved via small-scale, let's say, solutions such as scripts, session files, user toolbars, and more. As a quick flashback, up to now, many functionality has been implemented through Python scripting and APIs. So throughout all these years, Python scripting language has matured, it has shown its power, leading to powerful product customization. We have also successfully implemented the integration of scientific packages such as Python and NumPy in our latest versions. All this has led to custom framework development such as Meta Python Report classes. As a result, the whole community, the whole CA community, has moved to Python. Now all beta deliverables are in Python language, and from the next version, extensive documentation and integration with Eclipse will be a reality as well. Thank you very much for your attention, and stay connected with us and our products.